वेलकम 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 बैक फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज सोनिया हियर फ्रॉम ग्रोइंग क्राफ्ट एंड आई एम सो ग्लैड टू शेयर दिस वीडियो ट्यूटोरियल विद यू ऑल. येस, नाउ अगेन इट्स अ डिकुपाज ऑन कैंडल बट विद अ ट्विस्ट. ऑफ कोर्स टुडे आई एम हियर टू शेयर अ न्यू टेक्निक ऑन विच विथ विच यू कैन डू डिकुपाज इन योर कैंडल. एंड दिस इज अ पिलर कैंडल ऑफ good size, like this is approximately 5 inches and this is quite good. This is 4 to 5 inches and I'm going to do decoupage work on this. And before we start this video, please make sure to subscribe to my channel, hit the bell icon so that you can know about all the updates, and hit the like button if you like the video. Now I'm just unpacking these this candle. It comes with a plastic packaging, but and it's a little difficult to open this one. I really don't know why it comes out in very smaller pieces. Okay, and so here is my candle, and this is one of the very very cool and beautiful decoupage napkin which I just added to my collection. I have already shared this design in my few of the previous tutorials where I had shown the collection of my decoupage napkins, and now I am going to use this. So I'm just looking out for more colors so that I can use it well. Now this is the technique. What I'm going to show is something which I have never ever done off camera, and this is the first time I'm doing it, so I'm a bit nervous. But I'm quite happy too. And okay, I need to check the size. So I'll start with this area. And okay, this comes perfectly. I think it is going to overlap, but just a bit. And that's okay. I think that's manageable. So this is one line of paper, and I'm going to have I need one more line, maybe this area. So this is really fun. Decoupage is a fun technique, mixed media is a fun technique, and with that you can actually decorate so many of the pieces which is around in your place, just around the corner, and you can give it a new look, which I always say that don't throw away the pieces, keep them, use them, and I think that's the best way of storing them. So here, I guess this looks quite good to me. Okay, now to give it a little twist, can we cut these into again smaller pieces? But before that, I'm going to remove my ply, and so this one has two plies and I could easily remove both of them together. Now here is my napkin, and this is another one, and removing your plies is really important because then only like it looks more real, it looks more good in your project base. So okay, now I am going to cut it into smaller pieces as it is as the design is there in the napkin. And you need to be really gentle with your decoupage napkins, and especially if you have removed all the plies, because these are really delicate ones. Now I have already done a video tutorial on candle decoupage, and that video is already live on my channel. You can check that, and that was something which I really liked, and I am so overwhelmed with the response of that. And this was the another technique which I really wanted to share with you all since long, because this was just an idea what I thought of doing, but I had never ever done that. So this is my leftover paper, these are my pieces, and I really don't know how I'm going to arrange it, but we'll see. Let me have a sip of my coffee and then I'll be back. Okay, it's time to start with our main technique, and like I said, I'm not going to use any decoupage medium, the decoupage glue on this. So how to stick this? And for that I'm going to use my heat gun. Yes, this is the heat gun which I'm going to use, and with this I'm going to stick my paper. So I'll show you how. First I'm going to blow my heat gun on one of the areas, and this is going to actually melt my wax. The candle is nothing but wax, so it is going to melt down my wax, and then I'm going to stick it. So I'll just zoom in the camera so that you can see it clearly. Now I'll start moving my heat gun in the area. So you just need to keep it moving. You can't just keep it in one place, and you need to make sure that it is melting your wax really, really, really well. And the moment it starts, I'm going to keep it here. And now again I need to run my heat gun on this, and you need to be really careful when you are doing this technique. And can you really see that it has started sticking here? As the wax melts, it sucks in your paper and it sticks to your decoupage napkin, sticks to your base. So you don't have to overdo this. It's just a bit of melting work, and this is good to go. I'm just pressing all the extra wax. You need to be really, really, really careful with this. Okay, so can you really see? Yay, it has stuck so well. Okay, I can see one corner here, and I'll just press it, and this is done. This is completely done. Now I'll start with my another piece, and I am thinking of sticking it just a bit of overlapping. So this is actually working out really well. I never thought that it is going to work so well for this one. Oh, I need to be a little careful because heat gun, the air what comes out is really, really, really hot. So I'll just stick my paper here, and okay. You need to be a little quick with this method because it dries up really well. And make sure you're not working wherever it's the AC is on, so that this step works perfectly. Of course it is taking some time, but I really love this method. This is turning out really cool. Oh, the heat is really hot, but it is fun. So whenever I see that wax has started melting, I just press my napkin really well. And can you see this? Can you really see this? This is looking absolutely, absolutely gorgeous. Now I will just stick this area a bit more. You just need to press it a little gentle as soon as you realize that your wax has started melting. And don't worry about it. This looks quite good to me. And I'm not sure, maybe with the decoupage glue it was good, but this one is looking really, really cool. So now I should add some other color here, maybe. Okay, let me do this in continuation only and see how it goes. So I've just put up my paper here and I'm pressing it here, and this is going good. So this corner has sticked. Now I need to stick my remaining areas also. Okay, so when your wax is wet, you can see it's shiny, but once it dries out, it's completely matte. Can you see the difference here? It's matte. This was looking a little glossy just few seconds back. Now I need to add one more shade here, and maybe I'll go with this one. Can I do it a little randomly so that it looks much more colorful. Okay, maybe I will add this pink shade here. And I'll just overlap this design a bit. Okay, so I'm going to put it here. Now I'll start with my heat gun again. Just be a little careful, that's the only thing you need to do. And this is so good to go. This is so good to go. Although I'm not very happy with all these melted candles, but I think if I cover it up with these decoupage papers, they will be good. Let me add something here. Can I cut this paper into smaller piece and then use it? Let's see. Okay. Oh yes, I can stick it here like this. So I just run my paper or my heat gun and then quickly I'm going to have it here. Okay. This looks pretty cool. Can you really see how nice this looks? I'm just going to cover up the remaining areas with the leftover pieces of my candle, and I'm going to use more of my darker shades. Okay, this is done. This is really done. And few more pieces of my decoupage napkin. You can even use your decoupage papers, but I think it will take some time to stick because it decoupage paper has thickness. So the best thing to use in this kind of project is going to be your napkin, because these are really thin. And they will be good to go. I'll add some pink here. Now the number of pieces you need to add is completely depending on the size of your candle and the size of napkin you have taken. So you need to check that. And don't go with this number of pieces, because this was something which I had decided according to the size of my candle. Can I add one piece here? Yes, I can. And I'll try to cover up as much portion as I can. Oh, this is actually the wax is drying really fast. So one thing that you don't have to be so worried that, oh, the wax is melting, it is going to hurt you. Not very much, but please be careful. Now, why the wax is not getting very hot? Because this is just a heat gun. I'm just doing it and removing my hand quickly. And anyways, it is drying out very quickly. So that's the reason. But still, be really careful. And if you are a kid, you are not supposed to try this without your parents' help. I think I should add one piece here and that will be good to go, because most of the areas have been covered. So I'm sticking this portion here, and you can see that how nicely it absorbs my napkin. Okay, I just ruin my napkin. That's okay. Here and there, just a bit of touch up. I think more than wax, you need to be careful of your heat gun. Okay, so yes, a bit more of touch up. Maybe I can use my scissor to press this corner. Oh, done. Okay, done. So here my candle is ready, and this is how it looks. So yes, with this napkin, this is actually a 12 by 12 napkin, but I have used only this. This is not even 1/4 portion of my napkin, and I have turned this candle into very, very, very beautiful piece. Although I think I could have managed my heat gun a little well, so that I don't hurt these. I don't know, I think you cannot even see in this camera, even in person also you can't even see that, but if you touch your candle, you can just feel a bit of a waviness, just a tinge of waviness, which is absolutely normal, cause absolutely okay, not normal, but okay to have in your room decor. But this is looking really, really gorgeous, and you really don't have to worry that once you burn the candle, what will happen to the Mod Podge? Do I need to varnish it? Do I need to do anything? You know, you don't have to do anything, because here, if you rub it, I'll just show you. If you rub this, can you see some wax coming out? The white portion on my nails. Yeah, that's the wax. I'll just show you. That's the wax. This area is wax. So, once you use your heat gun, press or paper, the decoupage tissues on the candle, it actually, the candle absorbs your napkin and it sinks inside. So there's nothing outside. If you touch it, it's completely, completely wax. So this is just perfect for your home decor. And this was a real quick and a beautiful candle making tutorial. And I hope you all enjoyed this tutorial. And yes, I'm listing all the supplies down in description box. Yes, one thing. Many times I've been asked that, can we use blow dryer instead of heat gun? No, you cannot use your blow dryer unless until you are looking for something very generic thing, like just drying out something or blowing something. The heat gun is completely different. Your hair dryer is completely different. There are two different things, and it does not serve your crafting purpose. So please go for this one. I absolutely love this heat gun. I've been using this for quite some time now, and I'm very, 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 very happy with this product. I'm listing down all the supplies linked down in the description box. Do check that. And still, if you have any queries, please do comment below. I'll be more than happy to help you all. And I have a very small request. If you have any queries, please do comment below. And checking messages on my WhatsApp, my Messenger, or any other platform is really difficult for me. And one source of connecting with me is either my YouTube comment section, or you can join my Facebook group where you can share your artwork. If you do something handy, I would love to see that, and I would love to share that with the more than 1,000 people in that group, and I'm sure people will appreciate your work too. So yes, I'm sharing down all the links down below. Do check that. Thank you so much for watching. Take care. Bye bye. De nos lèvres, de doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter, de son ciseau d'enfer, des souvenirs impossibles à effacer. Le bonheur est passé à deux doigts de nos lèvres, de doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu.